on the lie on that one. I could watch that backside all day.
They want it. I want it more. I'm going to the Olympics game. Feel it. I'm going to win the gold.
Please. Are you nervous?
I'm terrified.
It's my turn, Joy. It's my turn.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the final event of today's Olympic trials. We have now come to the main event of our games, the running of the 100-meter finals. You've had a most successful afternoon, and I'd like to congratulate all the athletes who have participated in today's events.
You sure no one can beat him?
Oh, sure, I'm sure. Just a little concerned about that big baldy.
Let me first congratulate our athletes on a splendid performance.
Let me remind them that only the top four finishers will earn the right to represent Jamaica in the forthcoming Summer Games in Seoul, Korea.
Please. You're Therese Bannock, right?
That's me.
Well, I hope I make the team. It'll be a real honor to run with you. Good luck to you.
Good luck to you.
Therese Bannock. Hey, good luck to you too.
Runners, take your marks. Get set.
Thank you.
boxing or your cycling. Those are the only other two sports in which Jamaica competes.
I am not a boxer. I'm a runner. And it wasn't fair.
It rarely is, my boy. It rarely is.
Well, Papa, what do I do now?
Look, Therese, let it go, Ian. Let it go. You will have another chance in 4 years.
Yeah. Mr. Quidditch, who's the other man who picks you with my father?
Oh, Irving Britzer. He's an American who lives here. Unless, of course, he's been arrested or shot.
Excuse me?
Well, he's a bookie now. Takes his bets in a small pool hall just past Sandybay.
Isn't that the gold medal around his neck?
Oh, yeah. That lunatic was an Olympic bobster who tried to get your father to switch sports. He had some theory about using track sprinters to push the bobsled. Some ridiculous thing like that. Can you imagine a Jamaican bobsled?
Are you sure this man, he lives on the island?
Oh, yes.
Mr. Coolidge, thanks a lot.
Good, Iris.
Oh, can I borrow this picture?
Bring it back.
Yes, thanks a lot, Mr. Coolidge. Oh, just one more thing. What's a bobsled? That's a bobsled.
Oh, so a bobsled is a push cart with no wheels.
That's what it looks like here.
Let me see that. All right, the key elements for a successful sled team are a steady driver and three strong runners to push off down the ice. Ice! Ice!
It's kind of a winter sport, you know.
You mean winter as in ice?
Maybe.
You mean winter as in igloos and Eskimos and penguins and ice?
Possibly.
See you.
Where you going?
I want to take a hat back. I'm getting cold just thinking about all this ice.
No, man. You're going to be part of the bobsled team.
What do you need me for?
Who is the best push car driver in all of Jamaica?
You're looking at him.
And you got to do it.
No.
Hey, man, you could be famous. You could have the picture on a Wheaties box. But you said no, and that's all right. Because I don't need you. Everybody is going to want to be on my bobsled team.
Look, Star, let me tell you a little something, all right? When you need something from me, you don't have to hand me a bunch of lines. All you have to do is look at me in the eye and say, Sanka, you are my best friend. We've been through a whole heap together, and I really, really need you.
Sanka, you're right. And you are my best friend. We've been through a whole lot together.
Heap.
Sorry, man. Whole heap together.
And I really, really need you.
And I really, really need you.
Forget it.
But you just said if I said that, man.
All right. All right, man. So, let's talk about this bobsled team.
No, bobsled team.
Whoever. Now, about the Wheaties box, I'm going to be on it by myself, right?
No, man, you're going to be on it with me.
Yes, Tumbleweed, yes.
Come on. That's it. Good Tumbleweed, good Tumbleweed. No, Tumbleweed. No, bad Tumbleweed. What are you doing? Don't do it. Don't do that. Let him out. No, I need this one. Please. Come on. No.
That guy won 2 gold medals?
I think so.
Teammate Sanka Kauf.
Greetings, sled dog.
We were just wondering if you'd be interested in coaching the first Jamaican bobsled team.
Three. Remember the radio? Radio? Stick? Sitting in the stick? Let's go! Let's go!
Come on, coach. Just help me get started.
Whatever your name is.
Therese.
All right, Therese. Let me lay out some difficulties for you. Snow. You don't have any. It's 900 degrees out there.
Time.
You don't have any. The Olympics are in 3 months.
And me.
You don't have me. As far as I'm concerned, the sport of bobsledding no longer exists. I don't want to do it. I don't want to coach it. And most of all, and I mean most of all, I don't want to be within 2,000 miles of anyone who does. Now, did you follow all that? And how come you still have that post on the wall? Is that what's bothering you? There. Is that better? Are you happy?
Like I said, my name is Doris Bannock. I'm Ben Bannock's son.
I haven't seen this picture in 20 years. Would you look at me then?
Ooh, would you look at me now?
Please, Mr. Blitz. Just give me a chance. I don't have what it takes. But forget the whole thing.
Believe me, kid, you do not have what it takes.
But you thought my father did.
Your father was one of the toughest competitors I ever saw.
He ran 100 meters in 10 flat.
But I ran it to 9.9.
Come on. Coach me.
Sorry. You're a couple decades late.
Oh, I see. But it might be easy for you to walk away from me, Mr. Blitzer. But you can't walk away from this. 20 years ago, you came down here to see if you could make a Jamaican sprinter into a bob center. And you never got that chance. Look at me, Mr. Blitzer. I'm your chance. Take it. All right, everyone quiet down. Nice group here. Now for two of your lucky people, our trip to the Olympics starts right now. And I want to introduce you to Mr. Irving Blitzer, who's going to be our expert bobsled coach. Sanka, hit him on.
You're on the air, sled god.
Gentlemen, a bobsled is a simple thing.
Yeah, so's a toilet.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Basically, what you're looking to do is get your sorry rear ends from the top of an icy chute to the bottom. You're zigging, zagging. It's the biggest, coldest roller coaster you've ever been on.
Ice!
Oh, yeah. I almost forgot. One minor drawback to this delightful winter sport is that it's going to crash. Effort. Always remember, your bones will not break in a bobsled.
No.
They shatter.
So, who wants it?
Look, Baldy's here. Glad you can make it, man. Don't touch me. No problem. So what's your name?
Yul Brenner.
Well, it's good to have you as a teammate, Brenner.
Now let's get one thing straight, Panak. We may be on the same team, but I am no one's teammate.
As long as you come here to bobsled.
Hey, listen, man, the only reason why I come here is to get off of this stinking island. I have to take one of those bobsleds to do it then.
All right. No problem.
Yes, I have a problem. There's no such thing as a three-man sled. You're one Jamaican short.
Hey. Meeting start yet?
Uh-oh. You! No. I'll kill you!
Wait, I'll kill you! Hey! Wait a second! You're not doing anything! You're dead on the air! Kill him, and we don't have a team.
I'm not riding in the same sled as that.
You treat me too, you know. But in case you haven't noticed, there's no one else here.
You're crowding me, Slinkyhead.
Slinkyhead, that's a good one.
What are you laughing about? Nothing. If it wasn't for you, rich boy, I'd be in the Olympics right now.
I don't know what you all are arguing about, because Doris was going to beat both your butts anyway.
What are you talking about? How about I beat your butt right now?
How about I draw a line down the middle of your head so it looks like a butt?
Forget it, man, I'm gone.
Fine. Stay here on the island. We are going to Canada.
All right, I'll do it. But you better tell this mama's boy to stay the hell away from me. You understand?
No problem.
Hey, Irv, say hello to the first Jamaican bobsled team.
Oh, goody. Gentlemen, this is a bobsled. Sort of. All right, here's what we're going to do. You.
Don't touch me.
Of course, sorry. You're going to be the second middleman. You're strong, you're fast, and you're going to love that seat. Junior, you're the first middleman. You're quick, you're sharp. Hop in. Sanka.
I know, I'm the driver, right?
No, you're the brakeman.
No, I'm the driver.
No, you're not. You're the brakeman.
I'm the driver.
You're not. You're the brakeman.
You don't understand. I'm Sanka Coffee. I'm the best pushcart driver in all of Jamaica. I must drive. Do you dig where I'm coming from?
Yeah, I dig where you're coming from.
Good.
Now dig where I'm coming from. I'm coming from two gold medals. I'm coming from nine world records in both the two and four man events. I'm coming from 10 years of intense competition with the best athletes in the world.
That's a hell of a place to be coming from.
You see, Sanka, the driver has to work harder than anyone. He's the first to show up and the last to leave. When his teammates are all out drinking beer, he's up in his room studying pictures of turns. You see, a driver must remain focused 100% at all times. Not only is he responsible for knowing every inch of every course he races, he's also responsible for the lives of the other three people in his sled. And you want that responsibility?
I say you make Dorit the driver.
So do I, Sanka. So do I.
Oh, the back is nice.
All right, Father. Listen here. You see, I've made up my mind. I'm going to be a bobsled. That's right. A bobsled. Oh, really?
Well, I'm sorry you feel that way. Fine. Cut off my allowance. Because, you see, Father, a man has got to do what a man has got to do.
Just who I want to see.
Me?
You know where I just came from?
Where?
I got you a job with Webster. Webster and Cohen, the biggest brokerage house in Miami.
Oh, right. Webster and Cohen.
That's right. And you start end of the month.
Yes, but I thought that I would...
Look, we went along with this track nonsense long enough. And we agreed that it's time to get on with your real future, right?
I know.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Good. I'm going to tell your mother.
I guess we sure told him.
Winning a bobsled race is about one thing, the push start. Now I know you dainty little track stars think you're fast. Well, let's see how fast you are when you push a 600-pound sled. Now, a respectable start time is 5.7 seconds. If you speed demons can't whip off an even six flat, you have a better chance of becoming a barbershop quartet.
Bobsled team, sir.
Don't give me that business. I was born yesterday.
5'9! 5'9, you did it! You did it! 5'9, we can't! 5'9! Get out of the way! 5'9, guys! What?
Who are you?
I'm their coach. You guys okay?
Yeah.
How's the sled?
Yeah, man, we're fine.
Sled's okay? Well, it's in the wrong place. Get it back to the top of the hill. Let's move it right now.
I'm not asking for a winter sports program. All I need is a lousy 20 grand so I can get us to the Olympics. That's all.
How in God's name are you going to get to the Olympics? These boys have never even seen a sled race before.
Mr. Coolidge, I have been looking at sledders since I was 12 years old. If I say these kids can make it to the Olympics, they can make it to the Olympics.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you what we do. Practice down here with the boys a bit more. And when you're a little further along, I'll come along and see you.
No. No. No.
No, just a minute, Mr. Blitzer. This country enjoys a fine athletic tradition. And if you think I'm going to give you the little money we have so that you can parade us around in front of the world like a freak show, you've got another thing coming. It's bad enough how you embarrassed your own country. I'm certainly not going to allow you to embarrass ours.
No go, kid. That's okay, Coach. We'll get the money.
Do the words give up mean anything to you?
Not a thing.
Some people say you know they can't believe. Jamaica, we have a bobsled team. No people say you know they can't believe. Jamaica, we have a bobsled team.
Hi, I'm here to offer you an opportunity of a lifetime. We're looking for a sponsor for the first Jamaican bobsled team.
$9.52 from you, Brinner. Thank you. We got $184 from Doris and me. Sanka, how did your singing on the street go?
How did it go? It went like this. Enough people say you know they can't believe. Sanka, we have a bobsled team. Sanka, we have the one Doris.
How much?
I mean, $1.16.
Oh, that's great. We're only short about $19,000.
Sorry, I'm late, everybody.
No, that is terrific.
Let me pack a suitcase, Junior. We're not going.
That's too bad.
Whoa.
Oh, where'd you get it, man? I sold my car.
Yes, man. I am going.
No, we're not. Look here, Junior, I appreciate what you're trying to do here. We can't accept this money. It just wouldn't be proper.
Doris, if I hadn't tripped you fellas, we'd already been going to the Olympics. I want you to have it.
You mean you want us to have it, right?
Right. Us.
Thanks a lot, Junior. Thanks a whole heap, man.
Remember, this doesn't mean that I like you. You understand?
Be sure to thank your father for us, because Lord knows he didn't have to let you sell that car.
Well, he doesn't know I sold the car. he doesn't know I'm on the team. He thinks I'm off to Miami, and I loaned the car to a friend to work for Webster and Cohen. Some place like that.
Some people say you know them can't believe. Jamaica, we have a bobsled team. We have this one, Doris.
And no one, Junior.
You, Sanka,
the fastest of the fastest of Jamaican sprinters. Go to Olympics, fight for Jamaica. man. What you smoking?
I'm not smoking. I'm breathing.
All right, fellas, this is us. Let's go.
Move, move. I'll be burning.
What's the matter? You guys cold? It's not so much the heat, it's the humidity that's killing you. Excuse me, don't worry if you register for Bob's Sled. You know where you register for Bob's Sled?
Jamaican bobsled team. Okay, here it is. It says here your qualifying run will be held on the evening of the 10th. Your judges will be Schindler, Bremer, and Krojcek.
Krojcek. He's a good guy.
Yeah. In order to qualify, you must complete the course safely in 1 minute, 2 seconds, flat 400.
It's be a minute fine.
Yeah. Times change.
Herb?
Is that you?
Roger, how you doing?
Hello, Kurt. Been a long time. Obviously not long enough. Hello, Larry.
Jesus Christ, Irv. What the hell did you do to yourself?
Don't worry about them.
Roger, you gotta do me a favor.
What?
Please, you know that revolving restaurant thing? Meet me there in half an hour.
Half an hour?
Yeah.
Please.
$800. I just need something competitive.
For $5,000?
I know you've got something lying around, Roger.
Earth.
Anything.
You know I can't do that.
Wait a minute, Roger. Remember when you were desperate to make that last slot on the 68 Grenoble team, and you pleaded with me to talk to Kurt? Did I say, sorry, Roger, I can't do it? Come on, don't make me beg.
Roger, it's me. All right, maybe I can get you one of our practice sets.
You're a saint, you know that, a saint. You haven't changed to make yourself a saint.
Look, don't get all mushy on me. Just tell me one thing. Is this whole thing a big joke? Or do you really expect these Jamaicans to qualify?
Not only are they going to qualify, they're going to turn some heads doing it. Listen, three of these guys can run 100 in under 10 flat. I don't care who you are, that's lightning.
Yeah, but can lightning run on ice?
No problem, man. Swiss.
It's the real team, man.
Gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to the newest member of our team.
You won't believe what I had to go through to get us to sled in such good shape. If we're going to make it into the Olympics, this is the boat that's going to take us there. Well, I'm told she's actually quite fast.
Well, she's not much to look at, but,
she's beautiful.
Start?
Now we're gonna push start next time. For your first run, I'm just gonna nudge you off. Okay, Brian, let's go, let's go. Come on, come on.
Don't touch me.
Hey, Paul, get off my foot.
Don't touch me.
Hey, Blitzer. Why don't you put some training wheels on that sled?
That's funny. Very funny.
You want to kiss my egg?
I'm not kissing no egg.
Suit yourself.
Now listen up, fellas. I don't want you to worry about looking good out there.
Ah, Blitzy. You're going to touch him in, too?
Hey, seeming to you like nobody likes us.
We're different. People are always afraid of what's different.
Hey, Jamaica! Watch out for number 12 turn.
Scary, huh?
What's his problem?
He's Joseph Gruel. He's one of the best drivers in the world.
Yeah, he's one of the biggest assholes in the world, too.
So don't listen to him, you listen to me. Greece, right here, you got it?
Remember, keep your hands soft and your mind clear. High in, low out. What is it?
High in, low out.
All right, put your helmets on, everybody, let's go. Here we go, come on, helmets on.
Hey, coach.
Yeah.
I can't get my helmet down. Oh, thanks, coach.
That's what I'm here for.
Oh, coach?
Yeah.
I gotta go, you know.
Hold it.
Hold it?
Hold it.
Hold it?
Yeah, hold it.
But coach, I can't hold it. We're not bobsledding yet.
Oh, yes, we are.
Coach!
Coach!
Shut down that hot plate, fool. These bananas are stinking like a dead dog.
Back up, back up!
Hey, boy. This is my mama's secret recipe. And I hope you don't mind keeping quiet while I catch up on my reading.
What are you talking about reading? This is a children's book.
Oh, is that so?
Yes, that's so.
But if it's a children's book, that means it's too advanced for the likes of you.
What are you trying to say? That I'm not smarter than a little child?
No. What I am saying to you is that you are the kind of club-toting, raw meat-eating, meat-Tarzan, you-Janin, big ball bubblehead that can only count to 10 if he's barefoot or wearing sandals.
Say whatever it is that you want. Because you're just like every other fool on the island. You're going nowhere, Sanka, and you're thrilled to death about it. But you see me? You see me? I'm different. Because I know exactly where I'm going. And after I, you and Brenner, win the Olympics and become famous, I'm going to leave the island and live right down there. We're laughing about.
That's Buckingham Palace. You plan on living there, you're gonna have to marry the Queen. Ewell. That's where the Queen of England lives.
Face it, Ewell, Brenner. You can start calling yourself Madonna, but you're still gonna end up in an out-house shanty like every other dock working nobody.
Says who?
Says me, rich boy. What do you know about it?
Well, I know my father started off in a one-room hut. Now he lives in one of the biggest homes in Kingston.
Well, he ain't your father.
He doesn't have to be. All he has to do is know what he wants and work hard for it. And if he wants it bad enough, he'll get it. Look, believe me, Sanka, the more Yule Brenners we got making it in this world, the better off this world would be, especially for Jamaicans. Go ahead, Yule Brenner. Go get your pass.
What do you have in there, BB? I can't believe you still cold, man.
Cold? I'm freezing my royal Rastafarian nene's off.
All right, we're up. Let's go, guys. This is it. Give me that. Okay. Now, this is our first real push start. Don't worry about it, okay? It's no different than what we practiced. We've done it 100 times. Dorice, right here. Okay, get your helmets on.
Cool.
Okay, okay.
Thanks, Cole.
All right. Let's go, Dorice. It's yours.
Ridiculous. What's it doing?
One. Two. Three. Go, 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 go. Wait, hold on. Now. Now.
Pretty good, aren't they?
Good. At our best.
So you guys been having a little trouble out there, huh?
Ah, we'll be fine.
I sure hope so. It'd be real shame to waste all that talent.
I'm not worried. We have a good coach.
Kid, I hate to say it, but you gotta wake up. Coach Blitzer is what's killing you. He's been useless since the day he was busted.
What do you mean, busted?
The 72 games. The guy hit weights in the front of the sled to make it go faster.
So what? It's no big deal.
Having your gold medals taken away for cheating is a big deal.
Dorice, let's go. We got a meeting.
Giving my kid a few pointers, Larry?
Your kid's gonna need all the help he can get.
Coach.
Maid service, sir. Would you like a bed turned down? Mint? Perhaps I could dust your head.
Whatever's wrong with you is no little thing. Hurry up, man. I have a dead grandmother that moves faster than you.
Yeah. That fool won't know. Right.
Sorry.
What do you have here, man?
A telegram.
No, it's a telegram. What does it say?
For my father. He said I have to come home right now.
If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be here right now.
Wait, but you don't understand. He is really mad. I mean, you don't know him like I do. I think I better just do what he wants,
Go back home. And forget about your teammates. Blood, fire. The man you act like he's the king of the whole world.
What should I do? What should I do?
Hey, Jamaica! Keep it down. You're not only it to this.
Sorry, sir, sorry. I didn't mean to bother anyone.
You have no business here, Jamaica. You and your stupid friend playing like your bobsledders. Why don't you tourists go back to where you came from and leave the bobsledding to the real man?
Well, I'm a real man.
You want to say something, Jamaica? Come on, out this.
Tell me what you see.
I see Junior.
You see Junior. Well, you want to know what I see? I see pride. I see power. I see a badass mother who don't take no crap of nobody.
You really see all that?
Yeah, man. But it's not about what I see. It's about what you see. Now look in this mirror and tell me again what you see.
Well, I see...
pride.
Pride.
Right. Power.
Power.
A badass mother who don't take no crap
off of nobody.
Again!
I see pride.
Can I hear you?
I see power. I see a badass mother who won't take no crap off of nobody.
Once again!
I see pride.
Junior!
I see power. I see a badass mother who won't take no crap off of nobody.
That's very
right. Junior Bevel.
Where are you? Where are you going?
Listen to me, buddy. I will not be talked to that way, so you better come up with a damn good apology, or else.
Or else, fart.
How?
Literally. Or else, fart.
Come on, Jamaica. Say something.
No problem, man.
To know better?
Go on,
laugh. I want to see who's laughing when Irv gets here.
Now wait. When that East German fellow go out and push my teammate, and blood, fire, we have to fight back.
You don't see the Swiss team fighting, do you? You don't see the Swiss team drinking and carrying on and such?
And you don't see the Swiss team smiling either. In fact, if one of those Swiss boys ever come across a pretty girl, he'd probably yell, I'm fine, dry, and try to push her down some ice.
Oh, I took care of the whole thing. I told the owner of the bar these guys were mentally disturbed, so he's not going to press any charges.
All right. Let God does it again.
Just shut up, Senka. Now, maybe you haven't noticed, but we aren't exactly winning any popularity contests here. They hate me. They hate you. They hate us. Now, we're even going to think about qualifying. We're each going to have to sit down and take a nice deep look inside. I didn't come all this way to get my butt whipped. As a matter of fact, now that I'm here, I thought I'd do a little whipping of my own. Good night, gentlemen.
Rise and dine.
It's butt whipping time.
Turn 7, 3, turn 8, wait. Now, in a few minutes, you're going to get a chance to do something that no one in your country has ever done. I was going to save this for the Olympics, but I figure if we're going to convince these judges that we are world-class sledders, then we had better look like world-class sledders.
Oh, man.
Yes.
Nice.
I freeze in this.
Gentlemen, this is Carl Schindler. He'll be watching the middle track.
How do you do?
And this is August Grimmer. He'll be judging the push starts.
Hi.
I'm your third official up in the tower.
You? What happened to Krychek?
He came down sick this morning. I'm taking his place.
Oh, goody.
Oh, the Alliance has decided to change the qualifying time from a minute two to a minute flat. Is that clear?
No problem, man.
Go get him, kid.
Track's clear for Jamaica 1.
Say it again. Sprinters make the best bobsledders.
He is the sprinting!
So what are we going to name this sled?
How about Tallulah?
Tallulah. Tallulah. That sounds like a $2 hooker. How you come up with that?
That's my mother's name.
Tallulah. Nice. Like, what's it going to be, Star? What are the people going to be screaming when Jamaica take the hill?
I say we call it Cool Runnings.
You?
I like it.
Very strong. Nice, very nice. What exactly does it mean?
Cool Runnings means peace be the journey.
Peace be the journey.
Peace be the journey. Yeah.
Cool running.
Cool running. Cool running. Excuse me.
To the man in the orange suit. To the man in the orange suit. To the messenger. To the messenger.
We are officially disqualified.
I really have to talk to you.
Excuse me, Earth. I have nothing to say to you.
Yes, you do. I want to know why you disqualified my guys.
As you were told, your team must compete in an international race in order to qualify for the Olympics.
But in an Olympic year, the qualifiers count as an international race.
That may have been true in past Olympic years, but this year, the Alliance decided to change its policy.
Oh, please, change its policy.
The Alliance has the right to do whatever they feel is in the best interest of the sport.
We must also be concerned about the potential for embarrassment.
Oh, forgive me. I didn't realize four black guys in a bobsled could make you blush.
I think we've heard enough.
Come on, Kurt. What you're doing is wrong, and you know it.
Now, this is about you and me, and let's get it straight right now. All right, 16 years ago, I made the biggest mistake of my life. I cheated. I was stupid. I embarrassed myself, my family, my teammates, my country, and my coach. If it's revenge you want, take it. Go ahead. Disqualify me. Banish me. Do whatever you want, but do it to me. It was me who let you down, Kurt. It wasn't my guys. They've done everything you've asked of them, and they did it with all of you laughing in their face. And it doesn't matter if they come in first or 50th. Those guys have earned the right to represent their country. They've earned the right to march into that stadium and wave their nation's flag. That's the single greatest honor an athlete could ever have. That's what the Olympics are about. 16 years ago, I forgot that. Don't you go and do the same. Sorry if I interrupted your meeting.
Hello? Yes? Yeah. Right. Goodbye.
What?
That was the Alliance. God.
What did they say?
Oh, they said we're back in. Coaches have been giving you one of those win one for the Gipper speeches. I'm not good at that stuff. Instead, I thought I'd lead you in a psalm of inspiration. Let's bow our heads.
Who's the Gipper?
Our Father, who art in Calgary, bobsled be thy name. Thy kingdom come, gold medals won, on earth as it is in turn seven. Liberty and justice for Jamaica and Haile Selassie. Amen.
All right. Yes. Respect.
Junior? No, you listen to me, boy. You might not have done what you were asked, but you will do what you're told. You're coming home.
Yeah, but Father, you know, I just...
But nothing. I didn't send you to the finest school for you to go around sliding on your backside. He must be mad.
Yeah, but the team needs me.
I don't want to hear any more about it. Go and get your things. I'll wait in the lobby.
Father, when you look at me, what do you see?
I don't have time for games, Junior.
Tell me what you see, please.
All right, I'll tell you what I see. I see a lost little boy who is lucky to have a father who knows what's best for him.
No, you don't know what's best for me, Father. I am not a lost little boy, Father. I am a man, and I'm an Olympian. And I'm staying right here.
Junior Bevel.
You're a badass man.
Here, I gotta come up. I like this one. Yes, sir. I'm gonna be back. I'm gonna be back.
This is Al Trautwig, along with John Morgan. We're live at Olympic Park, the brand new bobsledding venue just a few miles outside of downtown Calgary.
Everybody shut up! It's talking!
Extremely intense, exciting competition for the next 3 days.
I am feeling very Olympic today. How about you?
And this sport, as we well know, is made up of athletes who go to the edge and sometimes beyond. And it's why we believe the next 3 days is going to be extremely competitive and exciting. And already, John, on day one, we're starting things off with the gold medal favorite.
Well, the Swiss, unfortunately, draw number one in the competition. We got to make them the odds on favorite to win the gold. But the East Germans are coming off the gold medal win in 1984. The Canadians, it's their home track. We got to favor them, too. And they've been doing that very well in practice already.
Surrounded by the ice and snow of Calgary, we are about to watch a team from the tiny island of Jamaica.
What a story for them to even get here. They came out of nowhere. You know, there's a lot of teams up here on top of the hill. It's sort of feel that Jamaicans don't belong here.
This time, 100 million people watching.
Therese, did you forget something? Thank you.
Ready.
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 Aye. Vai. Try.
Go, 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 go.
Dance. Dance. The team attends its first ever Winter Olympic event. Look at this. They've got to get into that sweat. I've never seen anything like this. I know it's not funny, but how embarrassing. Now, thank goodness, for a minute, I didn't think they'd ever get all four of them in, and that could have been a disaster.
Well, most importantly here, when you do get in the sweat, you have to give a cat-like movement, get in, get relaxed. Oh, look at that high liner, Omega, bounces off the wall, ricochets like a pinball. Yo, the driver here, Reese Panic, looks like the sweat's really driving him.
Better watch his mouth.
He better watch more than that.
This is the time that this team may be thinking, this may not have been such a great idea. Their heads are bouncing around this amazing, like rag dolls as they come through the finish at a time of 58.04, which will be good enough for last place.
You choked. It was yours for the taking, and you choked. You were ready, and you choked.
Well, maybe we should go over the turns again?
You know the turns. You know everything there is to know about this sport. I'll tell you something. You had all better figure out how to stay loose out there. That's something I can't help you with. I'll see you tomorrow on the hill.
You know, when the Swiss went...
Oh, shut up about the damn Swiss. I mean, it was all that Einstein dry nonsense that got us all nervous in the first place.
Hey, man, look here. I'm just trying to get this off on the right foot.
Well, the right foot for us is not the Swiss foot. I mean, come on, Darius. We can't be copying nobody else's style. We have our own style.
Kissing the egg is no kind of style. It's the Olympics here. There's no stupid pushcart derby.
Let me tell you something, Rasta. I didn't come up here to forget who I am and where I come from.
And neither did I. I'm just trying to be the best I can be.
So am I. And the best I can be is Jamaican. Darius, I've known you since Julie Jeffries asked to see you ding-a-ling. And I'm telling you as a friend, if we look Jamaican, walk Jamaican, talk Jamaican, and is Jamaican, then we sure as hell better bobsled Jamaican.
We now come to the second chance for the four intrepid men from Jamaica. What do they have to do, John?
In reality, I don't think the Jamaicans have any chance of winning a medal.
Dear God, just let it be better than yesterday.
Ready. Feel the rhythm. Feel the ride. Get on up. It's bobsled time. Cool.
Yesterday.
Well, this is an absolute shock in the making. Yesterday, they were falling down almost in the car. Now they slide as quickly. Yesterday, their heads were bobbing everywhere. Today, they're almost in unison. Can this really be happening?
Oh, what a different line through the Omega. Looking possessed here. It's not the same team we saw yesterday.
Where did these guys come from?
You in here?
Hey, Coach.
Oh, there you are. How you feeling?
All right.
Good, good. You all set to follow in your father's footsteps?
I think so.
You think so?
All right. I know so.
That's more like it. We're going to go grab a bite to eat. Want to join us?
No.
I didn't think so. I'll pick you something up.
Hey, Coach.
Yeah.
I have to ask you a question.
Sure.
But you don't have to answer if you don't want to. I mean, I want you to, but if you can't, I understand.
You want to know why I cheated, right?
Yes, I do.
That's a fair question. It's quite simple, really. I had to win. You see, Dries, I've made winning my whole life. And when you make winning your whole life, you have to keep on winning, no matter what. You understand that?
No, I don't understand, Coach. You had two gold medals. You had it all.
Dries, a gold medal is a wonderful thing. But if you're not enough without it, you'll never be enough with it.
Hey, Coach. How will I know if I'm enough?
When you cross that finish line, you'll know.
Welcome back to the bobsledding venue for this, the last day of competition. It's medal time.
And John, the top six teams are separated by only half a second, so it's very close. And that's been predictable.
I didn't expect to see you here.
Well, my dear, we've got a team in the Olympics, don't we?
Just honestly, it's the Jamaicans. They still have a chance to win an Olympic medal. Everybody shut up. My boy's on TV.
And you're not the only one to get excited about that. I think the fans here have an extreme case of Jamaican fever.
Yeah, so do I.
No. So do we. Do I have to tell you whose turn it is now?
Jamaica.
Respect!
Jenoff, you can still up here.
Next team up is Jamaica.
All right, fellas, that's us. Let's go. Here we go. Today's our day. This is it. Come on, guys. We can do it. The race. See you at the finish line.
With the kinds of pushbacks these guys are capable of, we might actually see the Jamaicans win an Olympic medal. So this is it. We could see history in the making.
Feel the rhythm. Feel the ride.
dead. I'll finish the race.
Thank you.